Hi everyone, welcome to the next episode of Real Sense Retirement. I'm your host, Isaiah Riel. In today's episode, we're going to talk about the coronavirus. Hi everyone, welcome back. My name is Isaiah Riel, host of the Real Sense Retirement Show. Today I want to talk to you about two things. Number one, the coronavirus, and number two, the impacts of it. Right now we're going through a correction, so I want to give some highlights about that and also some historical facts as to what's happened during these moments throughout history when we've had an epidemic, what's happened to the stock market moving forward when we've had those epidemics. So let me begin there. You know, it seems like it doesn't matter what we take a look at, it could be the TV, our phones, laptops, newspapers, every single station is talking about coronavirus and everyone being affected. I know, obviously, it's in many different countries. It's here in America. We've had a few deaths now here in America, heaven forbid, but we have. God bless those families. But it's in the news and we're talking about it. At the same time, last week, we began having a market correction in the stock market. And from the news that I was reading and seeing, you know, it seemed like the perfect excuse for us to have this correction. By the way, what that is when we go down the stock market by at least 10% from where we're at the all-time highs. People are using the excuse of the coronavirus to start selling their investments. You know, I know a lot of people, their heart, their soul, their net worth is built into their 401ks, their IRAs, their investment accounts. And good for you, I don't blame you. But when we have downtrends in the markets, when we have a correction, you start seeing that account go lower and lower and lower. I can see why for some folks, they decide, you know what? Oh my gosh, I don't want to go through this pain anymore of seeing my account go lower. I'm going to get out of everything. I'm going to sell it so that I don't have to feel this pain. And then once the stock market goes back up, I'll reinvest my investments. Well, a couple things that are typically problems with that. Number one is no one knows. I don't know, you don't know, no professional knows when to get out or when to get in the stock market. So how do we know if we can plan that perfectly? We don't, most likely. The second thing too as well is that, you know, these things are a brief blip in the timeline. I know when we're going through it, it seems like a lot. It seems like it lasts forever, you know, and I can understand that. But when we look at a long-term track record, these moments right now, these epidemics are just blips in the timeline. And so what I've been sharing with folks is, hey, you know what? We're going to respond instead of react. You know, it'll be funny to see in, you know, 5 years from now in 2025 or 2030, where we are in the stock market, where we are in the economy, and where we were at this point in history. But for the time being, I understand people's fears. And what I've been sharing with them is, let's respond instead of react. Stick with it, stay in the stock market, because moving forward, history has shown that, hey, it's been favorable for people who have stuck in the stock market during epidemics. So with that being said, let me share a few thoughts with you. And that being an article that First Trust Portfolios came out with last week in the thick of all this about epidemics and the stock market performance. And so what they did was they went back to 1980 until now. And you look back at 12 different epidemics that happened, beginning with HIV/AIDS, SARS, bird flu, dengue fever, H1N1, the swine flu, cholera, MERS, Ebola, measles, Zika virus, measles again last year, and now the coronavirus. And what First Trust did was they went back through all of those 12 epidemics, and they saw that, okay, you know, we know during that time it was a scary time in the news and in our society, but what happened to the S&P 500 after the height of all these epidemics? 6 months later, what they did was they averaged them all out. In fact, you can see on the screen here, I'm sharing them with you. You can see the returns for every single one of these epidemics in the 6 months. The average price return during all these, if you add all of them up and you average them out, it was an 8.8% return 6 months after the height of each of these epidemics. If we take it one stop further, if we take it one notch further, what First Trust did was, let's see what would it be like after 12 months from the height of these epidemics. They did the same thing. The average return from the 12-month mark, from the height from these epidemics till the 12-month mark, was an average of 13.6%. So the S&P was up on average 13.6% after the height of these epidemics. That was 12 months in the future. And so it's important to know that, because you know what? We, in the short term of things, we see the market and it goes, it goes up, it goes down, it goes up, it goes down. It can seem a little queasy to us. But when you look long-term perspective, the markets typically move higher and higher and higher. Of course, no one knows, I don't know, but history has shown that epidemics, yes, they last for a brief blip in time. And they may look like this in the short term, but long term, history has shown in a 6 month return, we've seen positive returns. In a 12 month change, historically, we've seen positive returns in the stock market. So again, I just wanted to share that with you. I know in the meantime, it can feel scary going through this coronavirus, but when it comes to the stock market, history has shown that, you know what? Markets are resilient. They continue to move forward even through epidemics. And so, hey, you know what? History has given us a good indicator. No one knows, but hey, you know what? It may be a positive thing moving forward for the markets. So I wanted to share that with you today. If you have any questions, any thoughts, please feel free to give me a call. I'm always here for you. I look forward to talking to you again soon. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Take care. Bye-bye.